Now let's see how to use a line integral in the rectangular coordinate system. Here's my x, my y, and my z. Let's suppose that I have a line of charge right here at y equals 3, and let's suppose that this line of charge has 4 coulombs per meter. It's uniform charge all along the length of the wire, and it goes from 0 to 4 meters in the z direction. All of these cases, x is 0. If I wanted to find the total charge, you can probably already do this in your head. You can see that it's 4 coulombs per meter and that it's 4 meters long, so my total charge is 16 coulombs. Let's do that with a line integral. So the line integral, I'm going to take my function, which is 4 coulombs per meter, and then I'm going to multiply it by dl. I want you to notice that this is the scalar component because I started out with a scalar term. So what I'm going to do is look at my line integral dl, or my differential length right here dl, and I'm going to pick the part that's in the direction that is changing. So what's changing about this wire? Over the whole wire, y is equal to 3, so it's not dy. Dy is equal to 0. In the whole wire, x is equal to 0, so it's not dx that's changing. Dx is equal to 0, so this is 0 and this is 0. The only part that's left is dz. Since I'm going to use the scalar term, I ignore the vector part and just use the scalar part. So I'm going to integrate 4 coulombs per meter dz, and z is going to vary between 0 and 4 meters. When I integrate this, I'm going to get 4 coulombs per meter times z from 0 to 4, or 16 coulombs total. Good thing these two are equal. Now, when might I have used my vector form of dl instead of my scalar form? Let's say that instead of 4 coulombs per meter, let me just change to a different color so you can kind of see these in parallel to each other. Instead of 4 coulombs per meter, let's say that I have a current. It's traveling in the z direction, and it's going to be 4 amps in the z direction. In that case, I would still be doing my 4 amp integral, but my dz, it's 4 amps in the z direction, and I would dot that with z dz. Then I would end up with this exact same integral that I've got here. It would be 4 amps in the dz direction. It would be 4 amps, and z is going to be from 0 to 4, so I would still get 16 amps on this entire wire. This should actually be in amps per meter. Sorry about that. Again, it's probably late night here. And that would give me 16 amps total on this wire. So notice, in the case that I had a scalar quantity that I wanted to integrate, I used the scalar dl term. In the case that I had a vector quantity that I wanted to integrate, I used the vector form of dl. That's how you decide if you want to use the vector form like this, or the scalar form like in our black case previously.